guy just cuts off this other truck right here. Start, stop. He gives him less than a 1 second following distance. His driver does. While he's running up the tail of that. He could have moved over there like right now and gave this guy that much more room. Following distance, you can see when you play it back, you'll see the shadow lines when he was over here in the left lane, how close he was. But just to give you an idea, he's less than one. And that flatbed's running up the back end of that other vehicle as well. Y'all jamming up here. Exit 81. Things that lead to wrecks. You get used to following like this, you're going to follow like that when it's raining out, you're going to follow like this when it's snowy out. Need to keep the truck back. I mean, if driving was that easy, just everybody would be doing it. That's what makes it difficult. It takes patience, it takes, you know, good judgment to be able to hold that truck back. Keep it out of harm's way. Start. Stop. 250. Watch this guy just cut on over. Move over to the left. He came racing down here so he could squeeze over and cut us off. Posted 55 for trucks. Right now we're pushing 68. The scale house is up ahead here, so I need to do something. Got a school bus that come on out. Hopefully your driver is not going to tailgate a school bus. He's tailgating a school bus. That is, that's something right there. Got the flashing light on the top of that school bus. There's a scale house. Bus might have been in, getting transported, but nonetheless, it's still a school bus. I don't know how you'd explain that on your insurance. Driver rear-ending a school bus.